Hi, I'm Greg with Science Museum Oklahoma. Today I'm going to show you how to make a paper airplane, and then I'm going to show you how to fly it really, really well. Okay, so here's what you need. You need some blank paper. Now, I'm going to show you this kind of slow, and then you can follow right along as you do this at home. Just grab a piece of paper. You may want to pause the video in between steps, so that way you can fold it and make sure it looks just like mine. So here's our first step. We're going to take our piece of paper, hold it long ways facing away from you, and fold it right in half. Now this is called a hot dog fold, because it makes it short like a hot dog bun. Right there. Now, you may notice I line up my crease really well on one side. And then, the crease is on this side, the edges are there, it opens up like a hot dog bun. Not folded over like a hamburger, but folded like a hot dog bun. That's the first step. It's a hot dog fold. The second step is a housetop fold. So you open up your hot dog, and then you take this edge from the center crease of your hot dog bun to this outside, and I bring this edge down and line it up with the center crease very, very carefully like that. Okay, that's one side of my housetop roof. There is the other side of my housetop roof. Now, if you put good, sharp creases on this, your airplane will fly really straight. That doesn't mean it'll fly better. It'll fly really straight, okay? So that's my housetop fold. Now, the next step is the tornado fold. I'm gonna take my housetop right here and just put it right inside my living room, just like that. So I get a shape that looks something like this. Some people call it an envelope fold. I have no idea why. I like to call it the tornado fold. The next step is one you wanna watch carefully. So watch this whole step before you try it. This is step number 4. I've got the hot dog fold, the housetop fold, the tornado fold, and step number 4 is called the shawl fold. I'm gonna take my thumb of my left hand, since I'm right-handed, and cover that housetop. And then I'm gonna take this corner where the housetop runs into the wall, and I'm gonna bring it down. I'm gonna touch it to the center crease, but I'm not gonna touch it at the housetop. That's why I'm covering that with my thumb. I'm gonna touch it just a little ways above, and then I'm gonna crease it just like that. And then I'm gonna bring the other side down so that both these corners just barely touch each other right on that center crease. And then I put good creases on them. So I wind up with a shape that looks like this. It's called a shawl fold because if you take a shawl, you wrap it over your shoulders, it could serve as a winter coat. There we go, the shawl fold. Now, I'm almost done. Don't worry, it gets easier from here. The next step is called the bird beak fold. Take this housetop, fold it right up over those two corners of the shawl, and there's my bird beak fold. Okay, two more steps to go. I'm gonna fold this whole thing in half, hot dog style, with the bird beak on the outside, just like that. And the last step is to make the wings. So here's what I do. I take this edge right here, the longest, second longest side on my airplane, and I line it up with the longest side on my airplane like this. In one long, skinny, almost triangle, except the point's cut off, all the way from the front to the back. Line it up just like that. Then, turn it over, line this one up so that they both match. Ta-da, your airplane's done. Then take it, spread it out into a T, grab it right there by the bird beak, give it a gentle toss, and it should fly. When you're flying your airplane, you have to make some corrections to its flight. So give it a gentle toss. If you throw it and you notice it goes nose straight down into the ground, you want to take these back corners of the airplane. They're called elevons because that's an elevator and an aileron combined. And you just give it a slight curl upward like that. Then when it flies through the air moves over it, hits these two things. That upward angle there pushes this down and causes your airplane to go up. If your airplane goes up, even if it goes up and stalls and then falls back down again, you want to curve these slightly downward. It doesn't take much curve, just a hair. Okay, the other thing that can happen to your airplane is it'll curve one direction or the other. Now, if it curves like this to my left, what I want to do is I want to push this side down and this side up. So if my airplane's flying left, I put my left side down, my right side up. That pushes this side this direction, this side this way, and that makes it curve back to the right again as it flies along. Ta-da! So, build you an airplane. Take it outside, inside, it doesn't matter, and adjust it so it flies perfectly, and there you go. So, have fun. Enjoy Science of Airplanes. Be sure to check us out for new science content every day at sciencemuseumok.org. I'm Greg. Have a good day. Bye-bye.